Yo, this is it on the place, Pokemon Black 2! We have gotten badge number 6! Which is awesome, that means we only have 2 more badges to get! And as you can see, we have a familiar opponent number 7, but it's not the Ice Sky Bryzen, nope, it's Drayden! The guy we faced off in Pokemon Black. Basically Black 1. If you played White, you played against Iris, but well, Iris is not there. Why? Well, we'll find out later, okay? Now we have a problem. You see, we got the badge, but we can't go through Twist Mountain. So the question is, what do we do now? We can't get to Curious City. How? It's because the Twist Mountain path is blocked. So now we're gonna go through a new place we have not been in Generation 5 before. Some place that did not exist in Black and White, but makes its debut in Black 2 and White 2. That'll be Lentimas Town. Then we're gonna head east to Reversal Mountain, to Undella Town, and then we're gonna head across from here to reach Lakonosa Town, and then we'll head into the very famous place, Opelucid City. Where we're gonna get badge number 7. So it's gonna be not 1, not 2, not 3, but 4 cities in total to reach gym number 7. So, let's get there. Now, in order to get there, though, Skyla said that, well, you can get to Lentimas Town through a plane ride. Let's go inside. Here we have Skyla here, alongside with the Juniper Professor.
Looks like the professor reached a stopping point in her investigation. Ready to hop aboard my plane?
Yep, let's go!
Ready for takeoff! Okay, Skyla, we're ready. Please take us to Lentimas Town.
Oh, we're not gonna go alone! Hello!
Wait! You guys, wait, wait, wait! I wanna fly too! I wanna do some research in Reversal Mountain! Bianca, you're here? You're starting to show dedication for serious research these days. Okay, everyone, off we go to Lentimas Town. Looks like everyone's here. Fine, it's time to fly the Unova skies.
And here we have the plane, not the biggest one, of course. And take off! There we see, it's traveling, soaring through the skies, the plane takes off. And here we are at Lentimas Town.
Well, I suppose I could tell you why I brought you out here. Sharon told me that a group of people calling themselves Team Plasma are planning to use a legendary Pokemon to take over the Unova region. As you may know, in the Unova region, there are two legendary Dragon-type Pokemon, Zekrom and Reshiram. But 2 years ago, Zekrom and Reshiram each recognized a trainer as a hero. They are following those trainers. So Team Plasma shouldn't be able to use the Dragon-type Pokémon. That's true! What could they be planning? There is much we don't know about Zekrom and Reshiram. That's why I want to hear about the Opelucid City's gym leader Drayden has to say about this. He's a Dragon-type gym leader, so he might know something. So, we're finally to the reason why I brought you here. I want you to go to Opelucid City and hear what Drayden has to say. And I would also like you to help me if something happens.
Well, of course you'd like to do that, so let's say yes.
Thank you. It really is the best not to get involved with Team Plasma to start with, but still, hearing what Drayden has to say about the Dragon-type Pokémon will be really interesting. And more importantly, it'll help up fill the pages for your Pokédex. I'll be in the volcano just beyond here. I'm going to investigate the rumors I've been hearing about a rare Fire-type Pokémon in Virginal Mountain.
Ooh, we like those rare Pokémon, don't we, guys? Of course we do. Alright, so here we have the landing path of Lentimas Town, the new type of town, bit of a desert-like town near the mountains across the other side of the Unova region, which is kind of cool because in Black and White we didn't go to the eastern side of Unova before we had
gotten all the badges and beat the Pokemon League. But in Black 2 and White 2, we're gonna go there basically around the time of now. Alright, so we're gonna go in here. Lentimas Town, where rough mountains trails lead. That sounds good to me. We don't really need to go to the Pokemon Center to heal, but we might as well just do it. Let's go to the Pokemon Center and heal. Just to make sure that all our Pokemon are ready to go as we are about to enter the next area of discovery. There we go. And this guy, of course, has some more medals for us. Let's see what we get. We get the Dowsing Beginner Medal. And we're also gonna get the Great Customer Medal. He has one more. Ooh. We get the Battle Teacher Medal. And he has even more than that. Next one is the Non-Effective Artist Medal. Didn't get any hit medals from him, but he wants us to get 50 medals and he gave us something great. So we'll see. And yeah, it's been a bit of a while since I did a Let's Play recording, so that visit to the Pokemon Center has gone us from through the winter, now we are into spring. Yeah, I had a bit of a Let's Play Pokemon break to do some other stuff gaming related, and also had another Let's Play of Pokemon of Chrono Trigger, which you can see on my channel. So that's why. But at least I recorded a lot during the summer, and now it's basically time to record again as we are into the autumn of real life. Well, not really much to do right here after we learned a bit, but there's one thing we can do. Enter this house here. And talk with the old man here, I think it is.
I am the master move tutor, and I'm also obsessed with blue shards. Give me blue shards and I'll thank you by teaching your Pokemon a move.
So basically, this guy has a lot of moves for us. If we want to teach him, we just need to give him 2 blue shards for last resort or iron defense. Mana Rise, Magical require 4 shards. Block, Hyper Voice, Electro Web, Icy Wind, Iron Tail, the 6 shards. Aqua Tail, Earth Power, Zen Headbutt, Soul Foul Play, 8 shards. Superpower, Gravity, Dragon Pulse, and Dark Pulse, 10 shards. So some of the moves are very great, some of the moves are situational, some moves I think are crap, but that's up to you how you want to strategize. At least give him some blue shards and then he will be give you some cool stuff. This guy teaches you about the move Block if you want to make that into your strategy, but generally I feel it's not worth the time to have. You're done through this very small town, you head east and you enter the Reversal Mountain Path, basically outside of the mountain. And yes, this place even has trainers.
Yahoo! If you call, I'll come right away!
Woo! We have a trainer battle on the eastern side of Unova. We're gonna face off against Cyclist Jeremiah with 1 Pokemon. That's gonna be, Sebstriker! The Electric Zebra is coming out to play. So Sebstriker is level 37 and my Magnezone is level 39. Magnezone, my MVP of the last gym battles we had against Skyla. Of course, now it's a sandstorm, that means all non-ground Pokemon will be affected. Alright, so Sebstriker is electric, so we don't really do a lot of electric damage to him. We can do steel, but I don't think steel is worth it. We can try. Sebstriker, of course, much quicker than us. We'll use Spark. Spark against Magnezone isn't very effective, especially when Magnezone as well is a steel type. So he has great defense. Here comes the cannon. It's not that very effective, but damage is still half. Sandstorm. And yes, the great thing here is that, yes, Magnezone should be affected by Sandstorm, but Steel types as well are immune to Sandstorm effects, meaning that fighting out in the Sandstorm with Magnezone right now is actually very useful. You can also think you dodge if you have a Rock-type Pokémon, but generally, yeah, Rock... Steel type doesn't really have an effect on weather. Rock up to level 35, catching up a bit, and that was the battle.
I'm on fire, baby, on fire!
Well, this place is a bit hot, I would say. Deserts are usually kind of warm. Let's check out the Magnezone here. Yeah, Magnezone looks pretty good, 39. How much about the Pokemon now? We have a bit of low levels here. Growlithe and Tranquilize to get up a bit in levels, but
We should be around level 40 on most of our team when we get to Opelucid City to face off against Drayden. We have not a trainer to fight.
Shift gears and Bob's your uncle. You'll be going full speed in no time.
Ooh. Is that so? Let's see what you have to offer then. Cyclist Adelaide with one Pokemon. And now we're gonna face off against Unpheasant. Now we're gonna talk about some strategy here for Unpheasant, because my Magnezone has a 4-time resistance to flying type. Both steel and electric are resistant, meaning that Unpheasant's flying moves deal only 25% damage, while Magnezone itself can take off a lot of health due to Unpheasant's weakness to electric. Let's go with Electro Ball. Here comes a taunt. Here it comes. That means I have to use moves that deal damage. That's the effect of taunt. Electro Ball lands on Unpheasant. Oh, he almost goes down, but he will survive. Oh, even the Sandstorm will keep it alive. Detect from Unpheasant. That means he'll be immune to our damage. The Sandstorm, though, will ignore it, and down Unpheasant goes. Almost 40 for Magnezone, and this battle is over with.
No matter how much shift cares, looks like I'll never be able to match your speed.
Well, electric Pokemons are usually having a high amount of speed, so I guess that works for me. Do any wild Pokemon in this place? Ooh, look at this one! If you guys have played Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire, you've probably seen this one before. It's Spoink! Spoink, the bouncing pig Pokemon of the psychic type, is available to be caught in this one if you need to get to your team. Let's see what we have here. Another wild Pokemon shows up. Oh, another one, interesting one, Scorupi. Scorupi comes from Generation 4, so in Diamond and Pearl, he's a poison type. And when he... I don't know if it's dark as well right now, but I think at least when he evolves, he gets the dark type, and that means he has a lot of weaknesses taken away from him. And that means he's very, very tanky. For example, a psychic type cannot really do any damage to him, and a fighting type cannot really do any damage to him, so he's doing pretty well. Let's see, yeah, we need to go into the hole here. That will be revealing us to the Reversal Mountain. But there's one more place we're gonna go first. That is because if we go around here through the grass, we're gonna go to another place here. Check this place out. What's this place? We just call it the Strange House. The Strange House, indeed. Looks pretty dead to me, but there are some things moving here. I don't like it. Why is things moving here? Is this a haunted place? Or what? But there are wild Pokemon here, and that includes this one, indeed. Litwick is found here, too. Litwick, as we found in the Spiral Tower. He's here too. He's a fire and ghost type, has a lot of special attack, but it's more of a glass cannon, so he won't really last long. So this is kind of treated like a cave or a dungeon in this game, so that means wild Pokemon will appear. If you don't want a wild Pokemon to appear for you, you need to use a Max Repel, or any Repel basically, but Max Repel are the best to use because they last the longest. I have 21 with me right now, so that's good. Remember, Repel only works for Pokemon that are lower level than you. If you fight a Pokemon that is equal level or higher level than you, it will come regardless of Repel being active or not. Let's go down here as well, see if we can find anything. And don't really see. Oh, there's an item there. A spell tag. That's very nice to have. We have another item here, if we can even grab to it. Yeah, this place is a bit tricky to go past. Can we move this thing? Don't think we can. That's fine, though. Let's just go up here. And we can maybe go inside here. Ah, there's someone here! Who are you? What's this? A visitor?
Oh, I'm so happy to meet someone else here. Could I ask you to be my opponent in the long-awaited Pokémon battle?
Yeah, sure. Just tell me what's going on in here. Why is things moving by itself? Is this haunted or what?
Backpacker Boone. He has two Pokémon. The first one will be Numel. Numel, the Fire-type Pokémon. Which is a bit of a problem for me because I'm a Steel-type with Magnezone. And Magnezone is weak to fire. So, don't use Flash Cannon here. It's ineffective against fire. Let's go with Electro Ball on Numel. Or, of course, I said you could use it. The problem is that Numel is also ground type. That means Numel is very tanky. Oh, look at that. Earth Power takes down the Magnezone. Because Magnezone has a 4-time weakness to ground. Yeah, about that. Luckily for us though, being a fire and a ground type Pokemon isn't very good either, because that means you have a 4-time weakness to water. So if I use Surf and take a wave onto Numel, the Numel will not last at all. It will take a 1-hit KO. Simipour is level 35. For our next Pokemon, we're gonna fight against Sigilyph. Sigilyph is a dual type psychic and flying. Let's game with Krokorok. Because Krokorok likes to chew on the psychic Pokemon being a dark type. Besides, it's time for as well for getting his second evolution soon. That'll make him very cool. Let's go with the Crunch. Sigilyph is faster, but Mirror Move will not work if it doesn't have anything to copy. So I'll Crunch, and the Sigilyph will survive. End it with a Rock Slide. You live with a Light Screen to reduce special attack damage by 1/3. Doesn't matter though, because Krokorok will Rock Slide this one rather simply, and it will go down. Too bad for Magnezone, but that's okay. Moxie, of course, procs from Krokorok. His attack power goes up. Even though there's more no Pokemon to KO, Krokorok goes to level 36. Now let's learn Scary Face. A move that reduces agility by 2 stages. But I don't really like using it. I don't think agility is not that important to waste turns on. Sure, agility can be good, but not Scary Face. Let's give up on it. It's more important for your own Pokemon to be gaining agility than the opponent to lose agility, because, at least in PvP, Pokemon battles usually have trainers trade in enough Pokemon to fight off against their weaknesses and immunities. This house doesn't seem like the furniture just moves itself. No, it's not me. I'm seriously not moving it.
Are you really?
Well, we'll see about that. Let's continue. Let's go up the stairs. Or I said I would continue the stairs, but it's not possible. Everything is blocked away. The furniture here is really nasty. There's even more wild Pokemon to show up. Yeah, remember that we had a KO Pokemon? That means the Repel goes for the next Pokemon Alliance, so Servine, who is level 33, will match a Pokemon at same level or higher. That means I have to switch Pokemon now for the Repel to work. I have to do it like this. Then we can continue here in the strange-looking house. What the? Who's that?
An everlasting dark dream. An endless dream of darkness. Dad, Mom, Abra, where are you?
This place is haunted. Just what was that? A repel? Yes, let's use it. Let's go around here, perhaps. Then maybe we can go in here or down here. Well, time is running out, so I have to do that next episode, guys. But at least we are now arrived on the eastern part of Unova. We have entered a new place in Lentimas Town. We are inside a strange house before gonna go to the Reversal Mountain. But things are really spooky here, that's for sure. Like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook. And that's gonna be for now, so I'll see you guys next time as my journey in Pokémon Black 2 continues.